Hello. The matter of our today's talk is consideration of heater control unit of combined case 2388. This is an aluminium box. Here is its part number of heater unit, heater module. Box contain two connectors. Bigger one has 37 pins, and smaller connector has only 16 pins. Other important elements on the board is controller, memory, EEPROM, two solid state relays, two voltage regulator, and four Darlington NPN Darlington's switchers. First of all, how to correctly power this module? We must apply a plus clamp of positive voltage from battery to pin number 30. Here is the same, but on the paper. Pin number 30 is plus, whereas a smaller connector must be powered with a lot of pins, for example number 5 from 7 to 11, from 14 to 16. All these mentioned pins must be powered with 12 volts of external voltage. Look here. When I powered the module, all these pins were linked with a wire, and it was applied as an external voltage to all of these pins. Ground on smaller connector is a pin number 1, and on greater pin ground is on 20th pin. When we apply this scheme of powering, the module will work, and we can confirm this when check signals on 15th and 21 pin. This is a communication pin number 15. It's not inverted, and 29 pin in inverted signal of RS485 communication protocol. Also, we can see that outgoing pins number 1, 10, 11, 16, 11, 22, 24, 29, 34. All these pins shows the voltage, will show a voltage of 8 volts. So we have ingoing pins for powering, and this pins, outgoing pins for control, that the module was powered correctly. But another what about a smaller pin? When we apply above mentioned power scheme to power pins from bigger and smaller connectors, we will get the following on the smaller pin. We will get meander on the pin number 4 here, and nothing more on smaller pin. Also, we have regulators, power voltage regulators, two voltage regulators, upper and lower. Upper regulator provides 8 volts voltage to power the board, to power elements on the board, and the lower regulator provide 5 volts, for example, for EEPROM memory, for communication chip. What we will get on these two solid state relays? Right relays does not demonstrate any signals. The outgoing pins of right relay connect to third pin of smaller connector, whereas left relay can get a control signal from probably from processor, from controller. This signal is a meander of 5 volts amplitude, and a frequency of meander is 2 hertz to in pin, and out pin provide the meander of the same frequency but with higher amplitude, 12 volts, and this relay provide this meander, delivers this meander exactly to the above mentioned 4 pin of smaller relay where we were talking about earlier about generation of meander on the fourth relay of of the four on the fourth pin of smaller connector. So, and now it's time to look at this NPN Darlington switchers. Firstly, let's consider this diagram. This is a module. Here's a header enable relay, which powers both module and three electromagnetic valves, which are controlled by module. For example, this relay delivers battery voltage to one clamp, upper clamp of valve, and another clamp of any valves is connected to module, header module, and this upper switcher, this switcher is responsible for for delivery of ground to the valve in order to current could flow from batteries to valve through relay, and then to module, which provide a ground clamp for current for this circuit, for circuit of valves. So in upper switcher is responsible for one action. This switcher, this second from up to bottom, is not involved in any operation of header related with header. Let's consider its application of these switchers. A down switcher is connected to this electromagnetic valve, and its aim to raise header, to pushing header up. As a second switcher is responsible for put header down. Third switcher is not involved in operation. I told about this. This switcher push the header ahead, moves the header and the reaper in horizontal directions, in horizontal direction, ahead and backward. If these valves, which are responsible for moving header in vertical directions, involved in operation if we have crops, reaper connected to header, and this valve, this upper switcher are involved in horizontal moving of header. If we have a corn reaper, as a combiner, attached to combine. So when we deal with crops, only two switches are working, and when we harvest corn, this third switcher is involved in operation. Generally, it's all I will not speaking here about my problem, which must be solved, because it is very specific problem. But all this consideration will be helpful, I believe. Thank you.